Hi everyone, today our topic about rational numbers. What is a rational? What is a numbers? In English, meaning of rational is logical, well reasoned, sensible, reasonable, intelligent, wise. Means agreeable to a reason. One example, a rational plan for education development. All these are the meaning of rational. Then what is mean by number? An arithmetical value expressed by a word, symbol, figure representing a particular quantity and used in counting and making calculation. Simply we can say that a quantity or amount mean numbers. To understand rational numbers, we must recall some necessary topics. In that, first, even. What is mean by even? Even numbers. A number which is exactly divisible by 2 and without leaving a remainder is called even number. In even numbers, remainder always is 0. They are called even numbers. Example for even numbers 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on, all are even numbers. Now another question, 0 is a positive number or negative number? 0 is not a positive number, 0 is not a negative number. So 0 is neither positive nor negative. Next, what is mean by odd number? A number which is not exactly divisible by 2 and leaves a remainder always 1. For odd numbers, always remainder is what? 1. Are called odd numbers. What are the odd numbers? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11 and so on are all are odd numbers. Then next, our topic, natural numbers. Now, what is mean by natural numbers? Counting numbers are called natural numbers. Generally, anybody ask you how many students in your classroom. Then, if we had a student of that class, we can say 30 students, 28 students. But asked you somebody count how many students in that particular class means how we can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many books are there on that bench? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Are called natural numbers. Natural numbers, the set of natural numbers are denoted by capital N. Means capital N are called natural numbers. N is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. In natural numbers, smallest number is 1. Biggest number is infinite. We can't say which is the biggest natural numbers because it's a infinite numbers. Now next one is, what is mean by predecessor? What is mean by successor? Predecessor means before number. Successor means after number. What is the predecessor of 3? 2 is predecessor of 3. 4 is successor of 3. Now what is the predecessor in natural number for 1? In natural numbers there is no predecessor for 1. Understood? So these all are about natural numbers. Then next, what is mean by whole numbers? The set of natural numbers including 0 is called whole numbers. Whole numbers included natural numbers along with 0 are called whole numbers. Whole numbers are denoted by W. Now the set of whole numbers is R 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. The smallest whole number is 0 and the biggest whole number is infinite. We can't say. And then next, integers. The set of positive numbers, negative numbers including 0 are called integers. Or the set of negative numbers including whole numbers, negative numbers including whole numbers are called integers. Integers are denoted by z are capital I. If z also integers and I also integers, then our topic rational numbers. What is mean by rational numbers? The numbers which are expressed in the form of p by q, here condition is p and q belongs to integers and q always not equal to 0 are called rational numbers. Rational numbers another name is quotient numbers. Rational number another name is quotient numbers. Means all fractions are rational numbers. For example, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 4 by 7, 5 by 8. All these fractions also called rational numbers. But all rational numbers are not be fraction. Vice versa is not possible. Understood? One more time. Even numbers 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. Odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. 11 and so on. Natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on are called natural numbers. Whole numbers. Whole numbers are including 0 and natural numbers are called whole numbers. Integers are negative numbers, positive numbers including 0 are called integers. They are denoted by Z or I. Next, rational numbers. The numbers which are expressed in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0 are called rational numbers. Rational numbers are denoted by q and rational numbers another name is quotient numbers. These all are basic information about rational numbers and which like explained in the textbook. One time you observe rational numbers. Introduction, when you have time, you read all of this. Then here, do this. Consider the following collection of numbers. 1, 1 by 2, minus 2, 0.5, 4 and a half, 33 by 7, minus 0, 4 by 7, 0.3, 22, minus 2, 2 by 19. Write these numbers under the appropriate category. A number can be written in more than one group. Natural numbers. Among these numbers, what are the natural numbers? One natural number, this 1 by 2 fraction, 1 by 2 rational numbers, minus 2 is a negative number, minus 2 is integer, 0.5 is a decimal, stopped decimal means a terminating decimal, 4 1 by 2 mixed number, mixed fraction, minus 33 by 7 a rational number, 0 whole number, integer, rational number, 4 by 7 fraction, rational number, integer, this is not integer, 4 by 7 fraction and rational number, 0.3 bar, it's a decimal, non-terminating and repeating decimal, 22 natural number, minus 5 is integer, rational number, 2 by 19 fraction and rational number, 0.125 a decimal, terminating decimals, which decimals are stopped, they are called terminating decimals. 1, 22 are the natural numbers. Whole numbers means you write 1, 22 including 0 also whole numbers. Integers 1, 22, 0 and negative numbers also minus 2, minus 5. Okay. Now rational numbers, all are rational numbers. Understood? Next, properties of rational numbers. This topic is we learn in previous classes about the properties. What are the properties? Up to 8th class, what are the properties? Listen. Closure property. Next, commutative property. Next, associative property. Identity property. Inverse property, distributive property. What are all of this? You listen. Chiranjeevi belongs to Telugu film industry. Nagarjuna belongs to Telugu film industry. If they both make a film, their team also belongs to Telugu film industry. That is called closer property. That it. For example, take here natural numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and so on are all natural numbers. Take any one of the natural number, 1. Take another natural number, 2. If you add them, 1, 2, if you add them, we will get 3. This 3 also belongs to natural number. That is called closer property. Understood? Now, my wish, I taken 1 first number, 2 as second number. Another student, maybe he can take 3 first number and 99 second number. Then sum of these two numbers, 102 also belongs to the set of natural numbers. This is called closer property. Assume that take variables. A belongs to natural number, B belongs to natural number. When you add these two, A plus B, their sum also belongs to natural number. This is called closer property. A plus B belongs to natural numbers. That is closer property. Next, commutative property. A plus B, if you add 1 plus 2, we will get 3. If you add 2 plus 1, also we will get 3. A plus B is equal to B plus A. 1 plus 2 or 2 plus 1, we got same answer. If when we got the same answer, we can say that this is under commutative property. Next, associative property. A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C. First, you add two numbers, then add third number, we will get one answer. Same numbers, you add last two numbers, again you add first number, we will get same answer. How? For example, 1 plus 2 plus 3, 1 plus 2 plus 3. You add these two, 1 plus 2, 3. Remaining these 3. 1 plus 2 plus 3, 5. 3, 3, 6. 5, 1, 6. How like you add, you will get the same answer. This is called associative property. If you get the same answer, then only we can say that this is associative property. Next, identity property under addition, under multiplication. When you add A with 0, roll of 0, 0 plus A, same answer you will get A. Identity property means you feel as a ID card. ID card, my ID card, in that ID card, my face is shown every time. Like, same number. Okay. Unfortunately, this video is stopped. One more time. Identity property means identity card. In our identity card, our face is showing every time. So, whenever you add a number with 0, always you get the same number. A plus 0 or 0 plus A, always you will get A. Additive identity is 0. Multiplicative identity, A into 1, 1 into A, again you will get A. Inverse property, A minus A, opposite, minus A plus A. You will get 0 or 1. A reciprocal 1 by A. 1 by A reciprocal A. You will get 1. Now distributive property. Here distributing A to B and A to C. We are purchasing. We are giving A to B, A to C. So this is distributive property. AB plus AC under addition, under subtraction. Okay. Now in the test book. Closer property. If the sum of two whole numbers is always a whole number, if the sum of two whole numbers, A belongs to whole number, B belongs to whole number, sum of these two whole number also a whole number, that is called closer property. If the difference of two whole numbers also a whole number, then we can say that closer property is satisfied under subtraction in whole numbers. A into B means closer property is satisfied under multiplication in whole numbers. Understood? Closer property. Next, in the textbook explained about addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Then next, commutative property. Here, A plus B is equal to B plus A. Additive commutative property. A into B is equal to B into A. Multiplicative commutative property. The commutative property states that the change in the order of two numbers on binary operation does not change the result. If you add 1 plus 2 or 2 plus 1, you will get the same answer. That is called a commutative property. Next, rational number addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, associative property. Here three numbers, A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. If you add first two numbers, then you add third number. Or if you add last two numbers, then again you add first number, you will get the same answer. That is called associative property. Next, integer, rational number, multiplication, subtraction. The rule of zero, inverse property, additive inverse. See, plus 3 minus 3 is equal to 0, minus 3 plus 3 is equal to 0. Additive inverse, multiplicative inverse means 3 into 1 by 3, 1 by 3 into 3 is equal to, you will get 1. Like all this information about properties, I hope you understood the properties. Now exercise 1.1. Exercise 1.1. Name the property involved in the following examples. 8 by 5 plus 0. 8 by 5 is equal to 0 plus 8 by 5. A plus 0 is equal to A is equal to 0 plus A. Additive inverse property. Second one. A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. Here we are distributing 2 for 3 by 5. Again we are distributing 2 for 1 by 2. 2 times we are distributing for 2 terms, 3 by 5 and 1 by 2. So this is a distributive property. 3 by 7 into 1 plus 0, additive inverse property. Additive multiplicative property. A plus 0, additive identity. A into 1, multiplicative identity. Again A into 1, multiplicative identity. A plus B is equal to B plus A, commutative property. A into B is equal to AB. A belongs to rational number, B belongs to rational number. Their product also belongs to a rational number, is called a closer property. A positive number itself negative number. Inverse property, plus A minus A is equal to 0. Additive inverse, A into reciprocal of A 1 by A, X into 1 by X gives 1. So this is multiplicative inverse property, additive inverse property, multiplicative inverse property. Next, 2 into X, A into B plus A into C is equal to A into B plus C, distributive property. Now next to second section, write the additive and the multiplicative inverse of the following. First, you listen, additive inverse and multiplicative inverse. First one number, what is the additive inverse of given numbers? Plus 5, there is no symbol, means plus 5. Additive inverse, just change the symbol, minus 5. Second one, 3 by 4. What is the additive inverse for 3 by 4? What is the symbol belongs to 3 by 4? There is no minus, means that is a positive number. 3 by 4 is a positive fraction, positive rational number. So its inverse is minus 3 by 4. Next, minus 4 by 5. This rational number belongs to minus. Okay, negative rational number, minus 4 by 5. Its additive inverse, minus opposite, plus. Plus 4 by 5. Next, minus 7 by minus 8. What is the additive inverse of minus 7 by minus 8? Here, minus and minus get cancelled. Okay, then 7 by 8. What is the additive inverse of 7 by 8? Minus 7 by 8. Next, what is the additive inverse of 0? Additive inverse of 0 actually plus 0 change as minus 0. But 0 is neither positive number nor negative number. So 0 additive inverse also 0. These all are additive inverses. Now multiplicative inverse. What is the multiplicative inverse of 5? 1 by 5. Because in the denominator place always having a number 1 for all natural and whole numbers. So 5 by 1 reciprocal is 1 by 5. 3 by 4 reciprocal is 4 by 3. Minus 4 by 5 reciprocal is 5 by 4. Here minus is there. So you also write here minus 5 by 4. 7 by 8 reciprocal is 8 by 7. 0 reciprocal also is 0 because 0 by 1, 1 by 0. Is it possible? No, it's not defined. 1 by 0 is not defined. We can't say. Understood? Now here, write the additive inverse and the multiplicative inverse of the following. First one, minus 3 by 5. Additive inverse is 3 by 5. Multiplicative inverse is 5 by 3 and this minus. Second one, 1. Additive inverse is minus 1. Multiplicative inverse is 1. Third one, 0. Additive inverse is 0. Multiplicative inverse is not defined. Okay. Next, fourth one, 7 by 9. Additive inverse is minus 7 by 9. Multiplicative inverse is 9 by 7. At last, fifth one, minus 1. Additive inverse is plus 1. R 1, multiplicative inverse is 1 by minus 1 means 1 by minus 1 R minus 1 because in the denominator place 1 is not valuable. Okay, with this we completed a second section. Now again a third section. Next third section. Fill in the blanks. See, B plus A, A plus B. If we balance these two numbers, LHS and RHS, minus 1 by 17, minus 1 by 17 is there. Minus 12 by 5, not is there. So here, minus 12 by 5. Minus 2 by 3, which number needed to add minus 2 by 3, again you will get your identity card, means 0, additive identity. 1 into, again 9 by 11, use 9 by 11. Minus 12 plus 5 by 6 plus 6 by 7. A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B minus 12 plus 5 by 6. Now remaining 6 by 7. Here 1 by 2, 1 by 3. 1 by 2, 3 by 4. 1 by 2, this side 3 by 4 not is there. 1 by 2, 3 by 4. 3 by 4 and 1 by 3. Minus 16 by 7, same answer, minus 16 by 7 means 0. Okay. Now next, multiply 2 by 11 by the reciprocal of minus 5 by 14. Okay, thank you so much. Please subscribe my channel and share it to your friends and family members. In further video, I will explain exercise 1.1, fourth problem onwards. Okay, thank you so much.